Hello, and welcome to today's presentation. It's my pleasure to be presenting to you today on behalf of American Media Output to describe to you our journey from our humble beginnings as visual artists collaborating over the internet to leaders of a rapidly expanding online marketing and brand design agency. In a moment, you'll hear how my partner and I first began working to create the imagery that would lead us toward expanding into a national, global, online producer of social media and food for thought.
Escobar Morales is an art team consisting of members Maya Escobar and Andrea Morales. Founded in 2010, the artists have been working together over the internet ever since.
Maya and I started working together over the internet a couple of years ago after a mutual friend introduced us to each other in an email. We were both interested in the way in which we could use our own bodies to reconstruct, deconstruct, and conflate existing stereotypes about the types of people that we supposedly represent. Having lived in totally different cities, really far apart from one another, we decided the easiest way to begin collaborating would be over the internet.
In their first project as a collective, Are You My Other?, an interactive identity dialogue exchange project, Escobar Morales began to publicly negotiate the relationship between the self and the other within the space of the web. Through this diaristic, blog-esque platform, Escobar Morales partook in the tradition of Exquisite Corpse, a game originally created by the French surrealists, where one writer would create a line of a poem or a story and would pass it on to the next writer. The next writer, without seeing what the person had done them before, would continue the story, and it would evolve from there. Within Are You My Other?, Escobar Morales assumed the identities of AM and ME, again, looking at the relationship between the self and the other. They would say things such as, am I her, or is she me? The true battle between AM and ME. With this hip-hop battle, jazz riff sort of exchange, Escobar Morales played with their own individual histories and merged them together into a finite work of art, sampling from Latino-Latina cultural iconography, as well as their own personal narratives. Escobar Morales forged together a dynamic, mythological story that is constantly evolving.
We wanted to create some excitement around our project because it was going to be broadcast online to anyone who wanted to tune in to what was going on between the two of us. So we decided to make it sound like this epic battle, Escobar versus Morales. And our first joint Photoshop collaboration was on a poster, an advertisement for the blog with the two of us posed as formidable MMA or boxing fighters, pretty much telling the world we were going to be in for a long ride and a long battle of interesting dialogue and exchange.
When Andrea and I first started working together, I was actually working as a promotional model for Amp Energy Drinks to pay back my graduate student loans. My job consisted of driving in a bright green promotional vehicle, scouting out boys between ages of 18 to 24 years old. Upon finding these boys, we'd get out of the vehicle wearing little tiny miniskirts and t-shirts that said Amp Up, and asked the boys if they wanted to amp up with Amp energy drinks because we were giving them away. As an Amp energy girl, I felt like I was a cross between a clown and a Hooters girl. I exuded this bizarre sexual energy that both men and women gravitated towards. But it was a very interesting power dynamic that came up as a result of both the clothing that we were wearing, the product that we were distributing, and just the way in which that we were situating ourselves on the streets. And from this, I really wanted to respond to this bizarre combination of sexuality, power, dominance, all at once, and through media and marketing.
Our first assignment to one another, which was to photograph ourselves as boxing champions, already revealed some of the really interesting differences between our approaches to self-representation. Whereas in my image, I wanted to portray a really strong, I'm gonna kick your ass kind of tough, rugged, masculine persona. Maya's picture came in, and although she was probably trying to look equally formidable, she was this sexy bombshell and was really kind of mimicking or using the language of, you know, a female fighter who's also, you know, maybe like a world wrestling kind of fighter who's, you know, just beautiful and sexy and kind of uses her sex appeal as an intimidating factor. And the boxing theme has continued to grow and spread into other images throughout the story of Are You My Other? And even started to branch out into thinking about lucha libre and the luchador imagery, you know, coming from Mexico, which has become really sort of popular even now as a part of American pop culture, using that mask as another layer of creating a kind of a sense of power in the image, and also creating a little bit of confusion amongst the images as to which one of us you're seeing there behind the mask threatening the other.
Inspired by the Jack Black film Nacho Libre, Andrea Morales, AM, created a post on Are You My Other called Get That Corn Out of My Face. During this time, Morales was in Minnesota visiting her husband's family, who happened to live on a farm. Morales photographed herself within the corn stalks wearing sunglasses in this post. M.E. Escobar decided to respond to this post by inserting herself within the cornfield. And here is where one of the most prolific characters on Are You My Other was born, the fat-free elotera. That's right, you heard correct. The fat-free elotera is a second-generation Latina human corn on the cob. Dale más, sacude, 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 perreale pa' que sude, se cure. Toca lo que sube, busca los guandules, no traiga lo azules. Déjala que empuje, mamá ahí, ella pide maí. Mamá ahí, ella pide maí. Mamá ahí, ella grita maí. Mamá ahí,
mamá ahí, papi dame maí. Mamá ahí, mamá ahí, mamá ahí, papi dame maí.
As a second generation Latina human corn on the cob, the fat-free elotera had to mantener la línea, or that is to say, stay in shape and be thin. This character is really heavily modeled after my experiences of being an AMP Energy promo model. I wanted some sort of persona that was going to depict the grandiose nature of being a mascot, but that was void of sexual energy. Although definitely, just as all our other characters evolve on Are You My Other, this character did as well. So as Andrea and I would go through and we'd be doing different things in our lives and different things would be happening, our own narrative was merged together into one simultaneously with that of the developing fat-free elotera. So you'd see the fat-free elotera painting murals or the fat-free elotera faking her own death to drop her hip-hop album, coming back from the dead as Calavera Elotera, riding a pimped-out speaker cooler bike. And then eventually attending the Puerto Rican National Day Parade, wearing a little tiny miniskirt and high heels, this character became one of ourselves.
There we go. Feel free to come dance with Calavera Bandera. That's what's up. You'll be in the next music video. This will be your chance tonight. Come meet her. The Fabri Eloteras back from the dead is Calavera Elotera.
In 2010, Escobar Morales became aware of the Buy Life campaign, promoting awareness of AIDS in India and in Africa. This online campaign, spearheaded by musician Alicia Keys, featured prominent celebrities who would donate their digital existence in honor of raising money for AIDS awareness in Africa and in India. Celebrities would pose in very glamour-esque shots, laying in a coffin. As people would donate money online, the coffin would light up. The way that funds were collected were by people submitting money in response to the celebrities not going online. This is what their digital existence was. They were not allowed to post on Twitter or on Facebook. Escobar Morales was fascinated by the way in which primarily the female body was utilized in tandem with a message of social good. They thought it was very interesting that the majority of people contributing to this campaign most likely had no awareness of the issue at hand. Yet, everywhere online, headlines read, "Kim Kardashian is dead." That's right, Kim Kardashian is dead. Kim Kardashian was the celebrity within this campaign that Escobar Morales took the most interest in. As a brand new reality TV star, Kim Kardashian was everywhere, and suddenly associated with this campaign, although very loosely so, the headline everywhere read, "Kim Kardashian is dead." Sexpot Kim Kardashian laid in a coffin, and there she was. People in response were supposed to contribute money to the promotion of awareness of AIDS in India and in Africa. Yet they saw a major disconnect. Escobar Morales was fascinated. They decided that they needed to create some work in response to this campaign. And with that was birthed American Media Output. Utilizing their initials, much as they did in the blog, AM and ME, Escobar Morales formed American Media Output. This fictitious marketing agency featured the two artists as designers, distributors, and even promo models. For American Media Output, Escobar Morales chose to deal with issues that were affecting both the American and the Latin American community within the United States, using their bodies to become the models that would delve into said issues. Escobar Morales created marketing campaigns that would reflect these issues.
Output is an online marketing and brand design agency specializing in American travel and tourism. Right now, we're traveling to major U.S. cities, gathering feedback from would-be travelers about two recent campaigns. The first is for an airline called Public Airways that specializes in travel to only the friendliest destinations in the United States. Right now, our ads show that they're proud to offer direct flights from Guatemala City and Mexico City to New York and Seattle. Our other latest campaign is a travel and tourism promotional for the state of Arizona, encouraging the idea that everyone should feel welcome.
Hi, so what are you doing here today in San Antonio?
Well, we're here at the Alamo and we're promoting Arizona. We've had some really great conversations with people today, you know, and people seem really excited to come visit the state. And we're giving away our ice-cold welcome water.
Atrévete, tete, salte del closet, destápate, quítate el esmalte, deja de taparte, que nadie va a retratarte. Levántate, ponte hyper, préndete, sácale chispa. Que tiene el área abdominal que va a explotar como fiesta patronal que va a explotar como palestino. Yo sé que a ti te gusta el pop rock latino, pero es que el reggaetón se te mete por los intestinos, por debajo de la falda como un submarino y te saca lo de indio taíno. Ya tú sabes, en taparrabo, mamá, en el nombre de Agua Iguaná, no hay más nada, para nada que yo te voy a mentir. Yo sé que yo también quiero consumir de tu perejil. Sónica como Brasil, tú viniste a matarla como Kill Bill, tú viniste a beber cerveza de barril, tú sabes que conmigo tú tienes refill. Atrévete, tete, salte del club.
destápate, quítate el esmalte.